Hi, I'm Christina Jeter here with the star of independent film ventures, Jim Ahern's Bloodline, where she stars as Emily Bloodworth. And we're here on the set location, and she's going to show us around on set. Cool. So, Nikki, how did you hear about this role, and what made you want to audition?
I saw the casting call posted on Pittsburgh Film Office's website, and it mentioned that the script was loosely based on H.P. Lovecraft, mm-hmm. and he's one of my favorite authors. So
that's exciting.
So that's definitely exciting. Piqued my interest.
Yeah, I would imagine. So let's take a look inside.
Sure. Yeah, so one of the neat things that I really liked about shooting here was all the different old decorations.
Oh, I can see why. It's really nice.
Yeah, lots of really great props.
It is really pretty. It's like spookily haunting. Any mm-hmm. ghost stories or anything?
Oh, I don't know. but let me show you the bedroom where we had our first scene.
Oh, awesome. I can't wait to see it.
So this is the bedroom where we filmed our first scene for Bloodlines.
Oh, wow. I love all the Chinese and Asian artwork. Mm-hmm. Now I see why Emily didn't want to get out of bed.
This bed is super comfy.
Disagree. So, how did you prepare to play such an unsympathetic patrician, Harris?
So, it was really interesting because to me, Emily's character is both sympathetic and unsympathetic. Mm-hmm. She's sympathetic because she's just lost her father. Mm-hmm. She grew up without a mother, so at this point, she's an orphan. At the same time, viewers are unsympathetic to her because of her attitude. She's a brat, she's racist, she just lays around in bed all day smoking and hating everyone. So it was really interesting for me to kind of get into her head because I've, up until this point, I've never played a character whose fundamental beliefs are so starkly different from my own.
Well, you did a great job portraying her. You've got over 2,000 plus views on YouTube. The fans were demanding more of you and even pressing on Jim to do this interview. How does that make you feel?
Oh, wow. That's great to hear. Crazy.
Yeah, it is. And, but, you know, you're such a sweet, nice girl. What other projects do you have coming out that fans can look forward to?
I just finished up a music video for a local Pittsburgh band, Bat Zupel. Mm-hmm. It'll be coming out late August, probably.
Oh, on YouTube mm-hmm. or on
yep,
channel?
On YouTube.
Oh, okay, mm-hmm. that's awesome. That's great. Mm-hmm. What role would you be a perfect role for you to land as an actress?
Perfect role. Not real sure about a perfect role. Uh-huh. At this point uh-huh. in my career, I just really like getting involved in different creative projects uh-huh. and whatever strikes my fancy.
Are you like into writing or directing? Have you done any of that yet?
I've done some creative writing on my own, mm-hmm. like just for fun. Mm-hmm. But at this point, no professional writing or directing mm-hmm. yet, but maybe one day in the future.
That is exciting. What are yeah. some directors that inspire you?
So I really like Darren Aronofsky, Lars von Trier. I love.
So how did you enjoy doing a death scene?
Kind of loved it. Dying on screen is like a weird thing that I really enjoy doing, so it was kind of cool.
So show us around, show us where this took place and how did you prepare for it.
Yeah, sure.
My, aren't you a vintage beauty? I'm just loving the Pan Am outfit. Did you watch the show with Christina Ricci when it was on ABC?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, wow. Yeah, you look just like it. So what do you love most about your outfit?
I really like the bag.
Oh, yeah, I do yeah. too. I love purses. Probably bet you have a purse collection.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Fit all my goodies in there.
Ah, Nikki looks very lovely today, dressed as a Pan Am 1960s era flight stewardess.
Thanks.
And you're welcome. I really love that bag. It goes well with the outfit.
Yeah, I got a lot of goodies in here.
Oh, I can't wait to see what type. Oh, wow. What do you need explosive for? Is she doing a whole Red Sparrow thing, Jennifer Lawrence part two?
Never know.
grenade. She's some type of secret agent. Mm-hmm. Oh my god, that's not real, is it?
No, of course not.
A silencer, what do you need that for?
You know, trying to be a little quiet.
Hi. See, is this one of what they teach you in stewardess school?
Mm-hmm.
Huh, that's interesting. Do you have that gun? Should you be having that pointed at me like that?
No further questions. Ta-ta, sugar plum.
My dear Agent X, I had begun to think you had forgotten the path to my humble door, and that your intolerant empire may have executed you by now. We need an agent of your caliber to infiltrate the vehicle assembly building. You, your unique credentials as an air hostess, put you in a good position to remain unnoticed. Now then, as to the VAB claim, the vehicle assembly building must be infiltrated. You have proven, beyond a shadow of a doubt, your abilities. Your rather unique abilities to deal with troublesome obstacles. Am I to understand that you are having reservations about your role as a top secret courier to our evil empire?
Well, depending upon the pay, that should gauge my reservations.
Perhaps then we could come to a mutual agreement.